simple verb or whatever. The good news is the length is what? It's just the integral from A to B of the square root of what? What do you think? F of t
squared.
Not f of t, that's wrong. F what?
Prime
of t squared plus
g prime
of t squared. I'm not going to, it's just an extension, simple extension of what you already know. Okay? H prime of t squared. D. Okay? So for this section, you might want to find out what the length of the curve is. Okay? So as an example, let's look at number 20. We have x equals t squared. Y equals t sine t, and z equals t cosine t, and let's just say that we just want t to range from 0 to 1, okay, to vary from 0 to 1. At this point, let us not even try to analyze what this curve will look like, okay? But because Okalski asked for the length, let's assume it doesn't overlap, cross itself, or so on and so forth, okay? And let's just kind of review the motion of how to find the length. So what do we do to find the length? We get the derivative of this with respect to t is 2t, right? How do we differentiate y? Y prime of t will be what? I think it's better to do it going down. It's going to be the product rule, right? Correct? So it's going to be sine t plus what? T cosine t. And then you need to differentiate z, you will get what? Cosine t minus t sine t. Correct? And then of course, what do we need to do with these guys? We need to what? Square each one, right? So it will be 4t squared, right? If we square this, what will we get? It will be sine squared t plus 2t sine t cosine t plus t squared cosine squared t. And I think it's better to write it this way. We'll see why in a minute. And then if you have z prime of t, you square that, you will get cosine squared t minus 2t cosine t sine t. I think I see it now why I did it this way. Do you guys see why I did it this way? Why did she write it vertical? Because then what do I want to do next with these? I want to add them up, right? Isn't the formula add? So then when you add these up, what do you get? So something squared plus this squared plus this squared will give you what? You have a 4t squared that doesn't combine with anybody, right? Okay? So you have 4t squared. What about sine squared t plus cosine squared t?
1.
It's 1. And then these two will disappear, right? Correct? And what about this?
T squared.
Yeah, it's just t squared. So actually we end up with a nice thing, right? For this problem, L will be what? Integral from? 0 to 1, a to b, of the square root of what? 5t squared plus 1 dt. Did you understand? So it's basically similar to what you were doing in 2D. You just add a third term, okay? And then of course the challenge here next is what? Integrate, right? How? We don't have time, huh? Yeah, we don't have time for this here because this was done in calculus too, right? You can either use a formula. How many of you used their table of integrals when you were doing calculus too? Nobody? Just one person? Okay. If you're using your table of integrals, you can use formula number 21. Okay? While I'm writing the answer, could you guys try to think, how would I integrate this if this were a test question? I see, I hear it. Come on, Keith. Yeah, arc length is usually hard, harder than surface area. Anyway, check at home if you can get this. If you have the time, try to integrate this. That's the formula to use if you're using the table. What kind of technique do you think we're going to use here? This for a calculus 2 class, what should you do?
Trig substitution.
Isn't it trig sub?